Now I want to start with one sum from exercise of a chapter share capital transactions. Observe the sum on the screen. I read the sum for you. Vadhavan Limited of Surendranagar issue 20,000 equity shares of rupees 100 each at a premium of rupees 20 per share. Now, when a company is reputed and is an ongoing concern with accumulated reserves and profits, may ask at the time of application, at the time of issue of shares, may ask for premium. Premium is an amount that a shareholder is, premium is an amount that a shareholder is required to pay over and above the face value of the share. Here the face value of the share is 10, and I'm sorry, here the face value of share is 100 and the premium demanded is 20 per share. So face value 100, additional amount demanded known as security premium, that's how much? 20. And that 20 is a part of 60. So 60 minus 20, 40 is the capital. 25 plus 40 plus 35, 100 is against capital and 20 against premium that the company has asked for. Company received application for 30,000 shares. Excess application were rejected and money paid thereon was refunded to the applicants. Amount due on allotment and calls were called up. All the sums were received in full except final call on 400 shares held by Yogesh. Past necessary journal entries in the books of company. So we are supposed to write down the journal entries. Now this premium is demanded with allotment. Premium is a capital income of the company. That income gets credited to security premium account. That amount gets credited to which account? Security premium account. And that security premium is demanded with allotment. So what is the journal entry when the premium demanded with allotment? Equity share allotment account debit to security premium account credit when the amount is demanded. Suppose that premium is demanded with first call. What's the entry for premium demanded? Equity share first call account debit to security premium account credit. Okay. Now, this is how the entry for premium demanded gets recorded. And when the allotment money is received or when the first call money is received, we receive the premium. At that time, we write the entry for bank account debit to share allotment account, bank account debit to share first call account. This is how premium demanded and received gets recorded. But if the premium is received with application, then how the entry for premium gets recorded? Amount is received first. So, bank account debit to share application account credit. And out of all applications, whatever the number of shares are allotted on that, whatever the premium that has been received, that will be credited to security premium account while writing the second journal entry for application segment. So the entry for that, first entry is bank to share application, second entry, share application account debit to security premium account credit. This is the methodology for writing the security premium. Now, first we shall prepare the working note and then we shall write the journal entries. Observe it. Now 60 rupees demanded with allotment including premium and premium is 20. So here number of shares issued by the company or capital allotted is on 20,000 shares. With allotment 20 is the premium capital 25 received with application, capital received with allotment 60 minus 20, that is 40, and the capital receivable with final call is 35. So capital received with application 25, capital receivable with allotment 40, capital receivable with final call 35. Now how many applications have been received? Total applications received for 30,000 shares. Excess applications are rejected and refunded. 30,000 minus 20,000. 10,000 applications are rejected. Now let us work out the amount. 30,000 into 25. This is the amount received with application. 10,000 into 25. This is the amount refunded. 20,000 into 25. That is transferred to capital account, share capital account. Capital gets due on allotment of shares and premium recoverable on allotment of shares, on shares allotted, premium due. The capital that gets due with final call at the rate of 35 rupees per share. So this is the capital received, this is the capital recoverable, this is premium recoverable. Capital and premium recoverable with allotment, this is the capital recoverable with final call. Now let us work out how much amount has been received. Yogesh, one of the applicant, and who is allotted shares, means shareholders, he was given 400 shares, has not paid final call. So 400 into 35, this is the amount calls in arrears, amount not received, though demanded. Now I want to work out the amount received with allotment and final call. Let us have a total. 8 lakhs plus 4 lakhs, 12 lakhs amount received with allotment, and here 7 lakhs minus 14,000. How much amount is received? 6 lakhs 86,000. After preparing the working in this fashion, I want to write down the journal entries for you. Amount received with application, bank account debit to share application account credit. Out of this 750,000, 5 lakhs transfer to share capital account, share application account debit to share capital account credit 5 lakhs, and amount refunded gets credited to bank account. Observe that. Bank account debit 750,000 to share application account credit, share application account debit 750,000 to equity share capital account credit 5 lakhs, to bank account refunded sum 250,000. Now amount demanded with allotment 12 lakhs, but 12 lakhs is made of what? Capital demanded 8 lakhs and premium demanded 4 lakhs. So capital demanded gets credited to equity share capital account, and premium demanded gets credited to security premium account. So equity share allotment account debit 12 lakhs, to share capital account credit 8 lakhs, to security premium account credit 4 lakhs. This is how capital and premium is demanded. And you know that we have received the total amount. Total amount received bank account debit to equity share allotment account credit. So this allotment account gets closed. Bank account debit to equity share allotment account credit. This is how entry for premium is recorded. Notice the entry. Allotment account debit to security premium account, bank account debit to allotment account. This is how premium receipt gets recorded. Now, let us go for final call. Capital due with final call, equity share final call account debit. 7 lakhs. To equity share capital account credit 7 lakhs. How much amount has been received? Bank account debit 6,86,000. To equity share final call account credit 6,86,000. Here I have recorded only the amount received. This is an alternative way of writing the entry. So bank account debit to equity share final call account credit. So final call account was debited with 7 lakhs and credited with 6,86,000. So there is a balance in share final call account. How much is the debit balance that stands in equity share final call account? Equal to 14,000, that is amount not received. So if the amount not received is allowed to stand as a balance in equity share final call account, then you are not required to write the entry, or you are not required to write the title calls in arrears account. So notice that 7 lakhs debited and 6,86,000 credited. So there is a balance of 14,000 in equity share final call account, and that balance is allowed to be remained or is maintained in this share final call account. There is an alternative way of writing this sixth entry that we have studied in the previous sums also. Observe it. This is a total of all six entries. Now I want to give you the optional entry for this entry number six, so I remove it. Bank account debit. Calls in arrears account debit. Equity share final call account credit 6 lakhs. Notice that here equity share final call account is closed. 7 lakhs debited, 7 lakhs credited. So amount recoverable 14,000 stands in an account known as calls in arrears. In the previous method, the same amount was standing as a debit balance of which account? Equity share final call account. So these are the two ways with which you can write the entry. You have an option. Either amount not received should be allowed to be kept in calls in arrears account, or the amount that is not recovered at the instance of final call should be allowed to be kept in final call account. So I have demonstrated the sixth entry in two ways. This is the optional accounting treatment, but let me continue with the previous one. So I remove it, and this total is in light of the previous entry. Now I have recorded the entry while solving the sum, while explaining the sum. At that time I have not written the narration. As usual, I'll show you the entire sum with narration. Just observe. This is how sum should appear in your notebook or in examination hall. You are supposed to write down the journal entry with narration, and I have disclosed here before you all the journal entries that has been explained with narration on this slide. Observe it. I think you have followed this sum. Thanks to all of you.